Hey, let me ask you something. Do you know what your nationality is?
Israel.
Israel, okay, you know that you're Israel. So how do you know that you're Israel? How did you know that?
I read.
You read? Okay. So you do. You know that you're Israel. All right, give me Deuteronomy. You know what I want, 10. So you know that you're Israel. Most of our people don't know that. Most people consider themselves African Americans, Negroes, right. So on and so forth.
Right.
So being that you know that you're Israel, there is something that is required of us as Israel. All right, so watch this, read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel.
What is your name? Israel, but what is your name? Right, your first
Albert.
Name? Albert? Okay, Albert, read.
And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
So God requires something of us, knowing that we're Israel. Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God.
That is key, that we must fear God. Read.
To walk in all his ways. And to love him.
Now, do you know what it means to love God? What does it mean to love God?
This is what I'm talking about.
You gotta follow him, right?
Man of behind us.
But the love.
He's still advertising and
it's to do his will.
It's to do his will. Okay, alright, so do you know what that will is? You learn, okay, all praises. And those are good answers, But we want to give you the answer according to what the Bible says, all right? Give me that, Psalms. Read.
The book of Psalm, chapter 40, verse 8. I delight to do thy will, O my God. Yea, thy law is within my heart.
So the will of God is his law. That's what the will of God is. All right, so go back to read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him.
And to love him. Now, we talked about the will of God. Now, let's deal with the love of God, because what you're going to find is that the Bible is very repetitive. All right? But they use different words to give definitions to different words, right? Watch this, read.
First John chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous.
So you notice that the laws in God, and the laws of God and the commandments of God are synonymous. Give me Psalms 119, 142, I'm gonna show you. And then we want to give you some laws to help us as a nation of people come out of the condition that we're in. All right? Got that? Okay. Okay. Real quick. All right. So let's deviate. Let's go to X. One more. X. A law. X. X is 20. And 8. All right. All praises. So you may not have known this, although you recognize that you're Israel. This law you may not have known.
Well, what's still within me?
All praise.
And then after they give me Numbers 10.
Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
So now it says that the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. Yeah. Right? It's his day.
Right.
In that day, he said, we must keep it holy.
Right.
This is how we keep the Sabbath day holy. Give me Numbers 10, 31. Numbers chapter 10 and verse 31. And these are laws that our people don't know about, right?
No.
Most of our people don't know. But those that do find out, I'm gonna show you what they do. Watch this, read.
Nehemiah chapter 10, verse 31. And if the people of the land bring ware or any victuals on the Sabbath day to sell.
Now the key day is the Sabbath day to bring to sell. So you got J&J food store. So they're bringing things for us to purchase, right? It doesn't matter where it's a Shell's gas station, whether it's Walmart, wherever. They're bringing things to sell to the Israelites. Watch this, read.
On the Sabbath day to sell, that we would not buy it of them on the Sabbath.
So what you see here is that we're not supposed to be buying on the Sabbath day. Now you said you were going to go into the store and buy. Now remember, these laws were only given to the Israelites, you being Israel. So this law applies to you, meaning we cannot shop on God's holy Sabbath day. That's a commandment. So, what is our job to do once we hear the commandments of God? Give me Psalms. Give me Psalms 119:59.
Okay.
Bruh.
Okay, all right, you gotta go, but so
I gotta go, bro.
Or understand this, bro. You can't shop on the day.
I got my daughter.
You can go, but I'm just telling you, you can't shop on the Sabbath. That's all I'm telling you. All right, read.
Psalm chapter 119, verse 59. I thought on my ways and turned my feet unto thy testimony.
So listen up, brother. The Bible says we must turn our feet to God's testimony. Read.
I made haste
to keep God's commandments, read.
And delayed not,
read.
To keep thy commandments.
We must keep God's commandments, brothers and sisters.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.